Oh, I didn't check the word record. Wait, is
it's
it still
the
time from yesterday?
It's actually the same.
Wait, it's still the time by Thomas. No way. It's still the time that the guy drove on the seating server yesterday. It's actually funny how often that happens with LoL Track of the Day. I remember that one Plinko map also had that.
Yeah, because nobody, not many people hunted afterwards.
Yeah, but it's still funny to be honest.
I mean, the reruns always have barely any players.
Yeah, okay. Hello.
Are we tired? Oh no.
And we gotta focus, Lars. We cannot take like 4 hours or so.
Yeah. Need to play well.
We go full Vamos mode later. Because for those of you that are not aware, guys, in the chat, for those of you who are not aware, after Cup of the Day, Lars and me will play an RPG Discovery event together. It's gonna be 10 out of 10.
They're actually gonna be sick. Also glad yeah. that you say, for those of you unaware, because I was unaware until like 5 hours ago.
Yeah, I had it actually. I put it into my calendar, that's why I remembered.
Yeah,
but good. Even a special map, there's like 50 checkpoints. I think there's like 5 boss checkpoints they called. And the theme is like flipping and stuns. So very, very interesting.
Yeah, and
could be really cool.
Like Hirash RPG setting. So, you know, like smooth in like a jungle or something like that. It look like.
Yeah.
Looks nice.
Yeah, will be cool for sure. Okay, we have a grass track of the day. Amazing. All my homies love grass. Okay, a lot of elevation changes. That's unique. Sort of. But in the ending, it's gonna be steering simulator.
You are. What? I'm not happening.
Nah. Yeah. My name is Grass, and I'm exciting.
Yeah.
Oh.
Tag first place.
Oh damn, fourth! Oh, oh no!
No! Oh man.
After all of us.
All of us winning yesterday, there would have been something.
That was honestly cool yesterday, that we all won our division. That was something unique. That will probably never happen again if we win 3 divisions at the same time.
Yeah, especially because we were only 3 people and all in different divisions. That's all
yeah. Yeah, true.
And the thing is, like, if you're then, like, on a normal track, like, Div 3, it's not as special. But on that map, like, any division boss just as hard, usually.
Hello, guys, my name is the Blue Challenge. What is this? Yeah, true. Also, some penalty grass here. Egg. Wow, Massa with a raid, eh? Yeah, hello, Massa. Did you finish the campaign? I only tuned in quickly earlier and you were still at 25 and like 0.6 behind. So did you get it?
Wait, if so, how long did it take? I bet on...
I think like 5 hours. It was on 4.5.
Yeah, I bet he gets it under 4.5.
How long did you need for the FS one? 4 hour 50, okay, easy, easy, easy. That's crazy though. How long did you need actually, Lars?
2 hours 50 or so. I could have had map 25 after like 15 minutes. Like after 15 minutes I had well record and then lost it in the bobsleigh.
The bobsleigh.
Yes. Well, that is because Karnati had a sick ending. I actually was with my time also equal to Karnati before the bobsleigh.
No, in the bobsleigh I went flying, you know?
Yeah.
Oh.
And couldn't even survive the turn.
That's also good.
Then it took an hour. Until I got it. At least
1 hour on the full speed map and 1 hour 30 on 25. Yeah.
Oh my god. The full speed map was okay for me actually.
Yeah, I think that's exactly like Cup of the Day on full speed getting Div 1. It is exactly like you can get that. But you can also struggle to get such a run. It's exactly that feeling.
Yeah,
it was kind of Div 1 level. Maybe a bit better than Div 1, I don't know.
Yeah, the thing is, my issue was that there were like quite a few speed slides where it was really hard to get the speed slide.
Yeah, for me as well.
Yeah, especially
I complained
at the
about it all the time.
Yeah,
the
same.
But otherwise, I guess that everyone despite the comments on Twitter, agree that this is a very good campaign.
yeah, I mean Twitter is here, yeah. Of course.
Yeah, there was this one hater.
I checked out Twitter a little bit before.
I am really not a fan that the hardest medals are on the desert camp. I don't know why they do that, because in my opinion,
because somebody
who doesn't already like the car, and then the desert car map holding them back from getting all ATs, I don't think that makes them have like the car.
Yo.
Doesn't make sense. Yo.
Yeah, look, that's why I joined. The only thing is that I think is so weird that basically on the arguably worst maps for the bigger audience have the hardest.
The hardest.
Exactly. Yep.
And like, true. I cannot, like, I said this in the end, I like hard medals, but like, what's the point if it's only on the bad maps? Like, I cannot play the good maps. Like, I actually liked so many maps, but I play them for 5 minutes, and then I skip, and then I play 1 hour full speed, hello?
Yep.
And then I play 1 hour 30 desert car, and then I play half an hour desert car. It's like, they force me to play the map that I don't like, you know? So... It's not like it's a difference, because on tech it's like 2 seconds until world record, on full speed it's like 1 second.
Okay. But the thing is, like, back in the days on, like, ice maps, they also always had easy ATs and stuff. I don't know why it's, like, why the full speed one is so hard.
Yeah, like,
the desert, I guess,
I'm
I just mean,
so
I guess, just
that you need SDs overcooked. On full speed, like, what?
Yeah, you need really good SDs,
and
that's
good
the thing.
SDs multiple, like, what? Already just needing one SD is surprising.
Yeah. I also thought, like, AT is basically clean run with no SD.
I mean, I don't mind it, though, okay. if I also need 20 minutes on the tech map, you know?
I wouldn't mind it if you needed 20 minutes on the tech map.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but on any other, maybe fine.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I don't know. It's maybe also somewhat skill issue, but I don't know.
Yeah,
like
but
only, no. I also only have 4 hours or something on the desert car so far total. But like,
but how is it a skill issue if I open the full seat map and the AT is 1.1 second behind no cup WR? And then I open the tech map and the AT is 2 seconds behind WR. Yeah. It should be the other way around, right? Because
on full speed has a cut.
I agree.
Yeah. So like, you know, it's not really a skill issue because but just look at the times, I mean well.
Yeah, I also agree with that. Like, you could argue it, but even
if it's not that big of a skill issue, you know?
Yeah.
Like, the gap is too high.
Also, like,
if
there's a car that doesn't take that long to learn either. To
I started learning this car in this campaign. I didn't do a single, so that's the only reason I took long. Like, and the full thing, of course. I mean, I spent 3 hours on 3 maps in total, so. Yeah.
That's like 3 times as long as any other full campaign.
Yeah. Yeah, the maps. Honestly, all maps were easy except full speed and the 2 desert farm maps. But I actually like desert. I like it more than the other enemies.
Yeah, that's what I also said to you. Like, it's
most
approachable, I would say.
It's another envy, like, you know.
The thing is, desert on the slidey surfaces is yak. Like, on plastic, it's horrible. Like, you don't need that. There's literally just, like, snow and rally car.
Yeah.
On road and dirt and stuff, it's kind of fun, I would say.
That's what annoys me, right? When I have an opinion, it's always, but objectively, it's just the same again. You just boost it again on this surface. It's just the same shit.
Yeah, on the off-road surfaces, it is. By the way, there is 2 tricks I have on this map. I don't know if you how it's looking with the scene, but you can most likely
jump right off that gate.
You can now right off that gate and checkpoint 1 to 2. You can no side entire start, but it's not much faster, like point one.
Fun.
Just in case you need the time.
I was doing that already.
And yeah, on full speed and such. For me, the problem is I don't play full speed, I don't play other envies. So I kinda need GPS. If I would drive into a GPS and then drive the map, like on Kappa, I would probably get the 1, like level wise. Because that's what I get, like on most maps. Like, I think I got Div 1 on every multi envy map. So, despite not playing them, I just need to see how to do it.
before as well, like the full speed map, the other time, that's basically a different time. And that's what you required now.
Yeah. Like for SDs, I just need to see the overlaps. I have no idea. Like, at all. No, I'm not playing. I saw the map and ended.
19. Yes, that's safe.
What's the gear change though? I left this toy.
The start? Yeah, I don't know. Epigenum is kinda dick.
What did I think of stunt? Yeah, but I only played two maps? I don't know.
Did you understand it? Or were you just
only
like,
played the first two maps? Because I played the first two maps before and they are so confusing. Because it's completely different.
Like the later the later maps made a bit more sense.
First
in my
map
opinion.
Was confusing. And I somehow lucked the 80 in like 5 minutes. I understood though, I think, with the combo. And then on the next map, I played like 5 rounds and I got the 80, like easily. I don't know, I hit the wall and then I landed perfectly. I don't know.
Okay.
I get it though, because I think it's you don't change an input in the air and then you need to land smooth.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah, like if you don't press anything for 1 second, then you get the master.
Yeah, perfect.
If you do it,
then
like, for 3 seconds, you get the epic.
Yeah.
There's actually a nice visual cue. I don't know if you saw that, but like you get trails after you're behind your car. And you get like a normal, you get trails like the thin trails if it's the 1 second one. They're like thick and a bit more bright.
As soon as you reach it in the air or like
after
exactly.
You... Yeah, exactly. Like once you're in the air 3 seconds, you didn't press anything, you know, then they get thick. Like,
okay.
Then you
and then they fail though if you don't land smooth, right?
Yeah, it's
I got that
fails.
Okay.
Like that is good.
Yeah, I kinda understand it though. It's kinda... It's
like I like those visual cues and stuff, but I don't understand what the mode is for otherwise.
Yeah, I honestly expected a Kappa, to be honest. Like, it could be implemented in
that would have been wild. But you cannot play it online, hello!
Like, stunt mode Kappa? Kinda cool though, you know? Everyone starts, there's a timer on the right, you only have one try, and then, you know, bottom gets knocked out with the least points.
It's not possible to play the stunt mode online with just time attack basically.
It's just solo player.
Nope.
Lol.
It's
actually it sounds easy to implement, to be honest. Like just set a timer and
a mode like that where you have no connectivity, you can't play it with your friends, you can't play it online.
You couldn't watch records, right?
It's like against the spirit of Trackmania. You can watch the ghosts, though. You can download and watch the ghosts if you want to.
Yeah, but you can download them from Trackmania.
Fantastic.
Great
solution.
The thing is, like, hunting desert maps, like, hunting for AT, okay. But if you actually go for world record, it's brain rot as fuck. Because you literally spend, like, multiple hours on one attempt.
Yeah.
Until you get, like, every checkpoint good.
And then if you, like, somebody beats you, you have to do all of them again. Like,
yeah.
You can't just restart from where you were.
No. Sounds fucking horrible.
Like, it's really stupid, honestly. I don't understand that, honestly. Like, the idea of that you can spend hours on one attempt to get summed up.
I also don't like that.
People want music
also,
louder in your
it
chat.
It doesn't make any fucking sense to me. I actually got mad at that yesterday. Like,
but I have a fucking IAR song.
Why do they bring out a stunt mode and specifically use the three United cars that just can't do stunts? They are so shit at stunts.
That's
true. And they are absolutely terrible.
Yeah, I didn't get either why the first map was snow car. I was like, huh?
And
at least
all of them, they can only do spins, like, it's just so boring.
It's a bit of an homage to the very first stunt map from Trackmania original, it's kind of similar to that one, I guess.
Yeah.
But, like, the original cars are shit for stunting.
Yeah.
But
like,
at least they are good
really
in inventing Epic, because all the nice stunts that you can do with coasts and so on, that none of those would land Epic. So...
Yeah, it's also... The names are also just a little bit weird. Like, perfect is the one that you don't want.
Yeah, I also said that early on. Like, why perfect is the worst one? I got a perfect shit.
Just do good grades, perfect. Like, I don't know. Epic master
but
champion.
Let's go, guys. I got an epic landing.
Yeah, there's also a cut already in the summer campaign on this one reactor off-road map I saw.
Yeah, but like, bro, I discovered it and I was like, yeah, guys, this is reactor equals cut. And then I saw this one part, where the cut actually was, and it's the exact same part as on the last plastic, the last off-road reactor map.
Yeah.
Plastic, with red plastic. But it's exactly.
You know what's also funny? Like, whenever Nadeo places a reactor boost, the chance that there's a cut is like. Increased by 10 million percent.
It's the exact same cut. So you jump against the same block. It's the exact same cut.
Yeah, I mean, we also had like this bobsleigh type of reactor cut like on 10 different Nadeo maps already. It's like always the same.
it's legit the same, like one for one, the same
yeah,
cut.
Yeah, I don't
know. The same wood, you hit the same block, the exact same block, the exact same speed. Okay. I don't understand. How can you be there?
Oh, firestorms also. Okay.
I would be surprised if it's even the same map number.
No, it's not.
No.
Okay.
Oh, wait. No, wait. It was map 16 previous campaign. Maybe really? It is.
Yeah, hello? Yeah.
But it's not the same block, I think.
And it is the same block. It's the scenery block with wood on the bottom. Like the grass one. No? Or am I tripping?
Wait, wasn't the cut last time with, like, on plastic?
Yeah, the blip? Last season it was red plastic uphill and then there was a white border. Or something.
Oh, against the white border. Okay, I thought it's the same. Yeah, could be. I don't know, I barely played.
It was plastic, but it's the same type. Like, the plastic didn't really make a difference.
Cut, at least.
Okay, it's like, just like you fly in summer, you have more speed with vehicle.
Yep.
But these cuts, okay, let's just say these cuts existed like on every map with reactor from them. Like, if they hit something and overdrop scenery.
Yep.
It's always the same.
Nothing new.
Let me go back and
if you look at all Nadeo cuts from like the past campaigns, there was always reactor boost involved, literally every
Why
single
don't
time.
Why did they look at it? Like, it's so easy to fix. It's so obvious that it's gonna be there. Okay, it's not the same,
but
it's against
plastic. I did saw one comment saying like Nadeo can't trust the community with reactors. I would say it's the opposite, like you can't trust Nadeo with reactors.
Yeah. The players just do whatever is fastest. If it's something yek, then the map will kinda.
So do you guys like the campaign or? Like, for me, it's so hard to rate anymore. I don't know, people ask me to rate it, but I don't know what to rate anymore. It's just another campaign.
I think it's better than
I would also think, already the fact that the ATs are more challenging is really good.
Yeah, but bro, it's...
But people have drifts, like... finally. Like, they are drifts.
Yeah, okay, that's true. That's true, actually. Yeah, okay.
I would also say, in general, like, in my first discovery, I saw many maps had, like, a lot of potential for time gain.
Yeah, I liked a few maps, quite a few.
I think honestly the maps are pretty good.
They look also
the
very
early maps are the always the same. The early maps are always whatever.
The first 10.
Are way more technical or competitive, I would say, this time. It's way more normal and not just in full speed around everything. Some random corners and jumps. Also, they felt like they have more flow.
Everything from blue on? Is it blue, the third one?
Yeah,
it felt good. Like every map.
Yeah, and white I was still skeptical because they were mostly so platformish.
Yeah. Everything's better than this fucking console campaign.
Yeah. That's the worst campaign ever, by far. Yeah.
I prefer it's 2020.
Oh. Oh, it's not okay.
Yeah, I have the same issue. These signs are in the way there.
Yeah, I hit the sign.
Yeah, me too.
That wasn't a good one. I
They are really in the way there.
But yeah, for me it's also hard to rate with the campaigns at this point because like, I don't know, like 2 years ago or something, there were like, I don't know, like eight campaigns or something. I would say, oh yeah, I think this is the best campaign we've had so far. Like, this is really good. At this point, like how many campaigns do we have? Like 20 or something?
Yeah.
I just, I don't have the overview anymore. Like, I can't say, like, oh, this is the best or something. Like, it's probably
to rate
probably top be... 5. I don't know, man.
There should be 16 campaigns by now. Like, yeah. 2 in 2020, then 4, 21, 22, 23. So yeah, that's 14, yeah, and now 2 in 24.
Yeah, but for me, you know, it's just always the same.
Oh, 3 even.
I'm kinda... I'm not... Like, it was cool in the beginning, it was cool to hunt the campaign. The first 3 or 4, it was like a challenge. People were hunting, you know, against each other. Then it slowly became less and less and less, and it's still the same. It's still becoming less and less and less. Like, sometimes it's like 1 month hype, 3 weeks, 2 weeks. And last time was like 2 weeks maybe. Now it might be only like 10 days. Next time it will be only 7 days. Like, it will be forgotten anyways.
You know what's funny?
Less, though, less, like, and less and less.
What is the solution though? Because it is the 16th campaign now. Like, yeah, how do you keep the 16th campaign fresh?
Like, there is no solution.
The thing is, it sounds exactly like Cup of the Day, what you described. Like, it's like we have 1,000 Cup of the Days already. At the beginning, it was super competitive, so many people played. It's getting less and less people are interested, because you know, it's
stalled.
The same.
Yeah. Stalled. That's why I said, actually, people flamed the stunt mode already before I discovered it, but... but I said actually that stunt mode sounds cool. Like, I like that there is a mode.
I said the same, I thought it could be really cool for, like, casuals.
I know, like that there is a game mode. I like it, like, that's what I like. I don't know, I didn't know that it's maybe a bit
big. I think they could have chosen some better maps for it.
Yeah, sure, some better maps, they can still fine-tune it, sure.
But also, the author times or author scores in those are, again, like, insane. Like, you need like, those epic scores or something.
Well, you played the first two and got lucky, I think.
I spent longer on getting the author times on the stunt than on the campaign.
No, shit. How many maps are there? I didn't
see. Only 10.
10, yeah, 10 but there will be 5 now every Monday.
Yeah.
And I didn't finish them yet. I'm stuck, like, I was stuck at the AO8 one. And,
every Monday and then it's an
offline.
Yeah, the
AO8 one is
What
a bad map as well.
I don't know, just randomly had like a master into Corkscrew 360, got 3000 points for that, or 5000 points or something, and then was done.
Sounds
good. I didn't even notice.
Oh, Lingo, okay, close round though.
Yeah, but stunt.
I feel like people will hate on everything until we will have like, I don't know, till we have some quality of life update or something people like actually want. Then no matter what comes out, even if it's like a good new game mode, people will still dislike it.
Oh yeah, did you beacon prac, Nico?
I played the full map a little bit we learned today.
Yeah.
And it's about as it's exactly as we thought it was gonna be. Not easy. But I didn't play that much. I actually didn't have that much time sadly.
Yeah.
I mean you can see my time there, it's like but I can still gain so much like.
Oh really? What is max?
But the time that I have on our practice map, I got it. I drove the pace kind of easily, but I just could never get a run which was like faster.
Yeah, that's the same yesterday on the map pace yesterday. So I only played 5 minutes, and I was like, yeah, okay, I'll leave it.
Yeah, the map from yesterday, I still gotta play.
Yeah, I'll play.
Tomorrow I will do like I will practice from like 10 a.m. Yeah, and then like zack vamos until I stream.
Tomorrow it's practice time.
Dude, this map is so random, huh? I do the exact same. Marius?
I don't get it.
Max?
Oh.
Do we already know the matches for the first week? Like, how's it even gonna work?
Yes,
respawn is very long.
Hey, Ender, that's all I know.
But we have like a quite low seed now, right? Like,
matches,
I guess.
I'm only like 80 or 90 FPS here.
Seed something, like 12.
Am I ready for our prac showdown? Yeah, well, I need to still finish one map. But I will be, no problem. I'm goated.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, like, are people like Barboss and so, are they even playing?
What? He's not there.
But, like, he's qualified in Division 1, technically.
No, he's not. I mean, maybe he was, but he declined.
Oh, I see something! Oh, interesting. Is he still first?
Backslide or what?
Yeah.
It's Epos, Bosspass, Ender, Elkon.
I had it in mind earlier as well, but I. Yeah, no.
Richie, Nico, Paco. Paco, but there's no Paco. There's Tween. There
yeah, but now he's pretty far behind.
Who was it? It's a rocket.
But
86 and I don't understand.
These two new maps are insanely good. So much better than the other three. Facts.
I wouldn't say they're much better. I'm sure. I also like them. Like the Kerberos map is very creative and definitely good. And the other one is just like clean and good, I would say. It's a bit less technical than like Vixar and Roxy map. And I mean, Intax map is just very dank. I would say all are pretty good. Like, wouldn't say there's a clear best map or worst map.
No, not at all.
Personally, I mean, I know that you hate Intax map. Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, I mean, objectively.
Okay, true. Vixar map in off-road parts, like penalty grass parts.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's true.
Objectively seen, the last jump on Vixar map is trash, and the start on Intax map is trash. Which kind of ruins both maps a little bit. But the other maps, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know about that Kerberos map yet. Hello?
Yeah.
That's such jeepers.
Why is Firestorm not in the voice?
And there's only 2 seconds behind on every map on Sunday. He just doesn't know yet.
How does that actually work then on with the beacon thing? Is it like a group stage now or?
Yeah, there's like a group stage, but sadly only one round. So you play everyone wants 60 players, so 5 matches I think. Yeah. And then top 8 goes to playoffs. The playoff bracket. I don't know how it works exactly, but yeah.
Wait, top what? Top 8?
Yeah. Didn't even know there's a crowdfunding, Michael, but I think you told me once, I just didn't listen.
Yeah, I also put it into the description of my YouTube video. Yeah. And we have 2k prize pool, 2k plus, I guess.
Okay, better than nothing. I mean, it's stream content. You can win like 1k maybe as well. I mean, why not? Sounds not too bad.
I mean, more fun than playing fucking World Tour Map
every month. Yeah,
even though it's more effort, of course, but yeah.
I mean, we learned the maps now.
Another thing with it. Yeah, maybe.
Now it's about training a bit. Best Suck! Training is matches.
81, somehow. Don't understand, but somehow I got 81.
No, you do the
My
same
start
everywhere.
Is so bad. Like I lose half a second, and after that I just keep the pace.
Regardless,
I think it's like,
don't get
like
the, do you get the gear or do you not get the gear?
Where?
Do you
the
release?
Start?
Yeah, like
release
after the first turn.
Release.
Okay.
Regarding the stunt mode, is it now actually important if your last stunt before the 10 seconds are over is a master, epic or whatever? Does it play any role for the points?
Does you get like a bonus if it's an epic or whatever, even for the stunt itself, not just the next one.
Okay.
Yeah, like in theory, it's just wanna spam epic stunts.
Was that written somewhere that this still gives a bonus?
No. Just gotta figure out.
That's what I meant with like hunting. Like you just hunt each single combo until you get like really good epic landings and stuff. And
yeah,
the
like
thing
this,
is, it does feel random.
Extremely
sometimes.
Yak because you can get, you know, like these landings, right? That's like a 2.5 times multiplier, right? And you get that for the next stunt. What you can do is go into like the map or something, and get an epic somewhere, then drive back to the start, to the checkpoint, drive to the checkpoint, and then the first stunt will already be 2 times 2.5.
Yeah, but then your respawn won't be like that, so you will have to do that every single time.
Yeah, you need to do it every single time. Collect the epic and then go back to the checkpoint. Absolute trash. Like that, honestly, should be like that. At least, I guess you should make it that you can't reach the checkpoint or something. Right, that was bad.
Yeah, you're on the edge. Still, but it seems good because I saw another crash in front.
Should stop experimenting at the start, maybe.
Runs are so close here because it's grass. Ah, damn mine, unlucky.
I just don't want to crash this transition, that one trick.
Yeah, but if you don't do it, you lose so much, you're out.
I'm the most scared of the start because I do the full speed nose slide every single run. It's a bit scary. Like I nose slide and then when I get the gear, I do like stop steer and then speed slide through the triangle. It's very scary.
I think pretty much everyone is doing it.
Like I'm so scared of that. Like I don't know.
I mean,
it's so easy to fail it, aiming wise.
It is easy to get an auto slide.
Me every round.
Yeah, I went too tight here and this, also I went just a tight line and this makes this transition more difficult to hit. I saw it basically 3 seconds early that it's gonna be difficult to hit the angle, but I couldn't really go more outside at this point anymore and I had like a small clip. Thought okay, it's maybe better to respawn, and then I realized that the respawn is before that long left turn, so it was miles away. Should have continued, maybe I could have continued, but would have been very slow as well.
Firestorm.
I'ma go, have fun, good luck.
Yeah, see you, bye bye.
Bye bye.
I'm also in red now every single time.
Okay, you're on orange now, I think.
It was risky, it wasn't
But it's very close, speed. The guy has good speed. It will be enough. Oof! Yeah, that landing was very tight.
Yeah, I tried to risk, it was close. Still 0.3, but I don't know, I was so much in the start.
I tried to fix some things on my PC.
Not yet, Benson, but will be soon.
Like with a CMD command by to fix broken Windows files or something like that and small other things. Seems to be better now, at least I don't have teleports, but the FPS are still so in the mud. Here in the spectating I have 55 to 65 FPS. And then playing it was also less than 100. That's something that I still don't get. Then I have better hardware than you last, I guess. And I have no FPS. But Fabian can also not understand it, so...
I guess you have actually set... your monitor settings and stuff correctly? Yeah, close.
Yeah.
My god.
Yeah.
Can I just get one good start? Like, I think you also half a second down after need a good start now. Like, every single time, I think. I don't get it. I just don't get it. Like, how can you say lower gear? I don't know.
But did you try it to say?
Well, Hell Vampire with the helpful unscrew. Good focus, Hell Vampire.
Now, and spam is in last. With a good gap. Yeah, a bit tighter last, but you still have it easy.
Calculated.
Lol, Nalax. No way they let spam through on purpose.
Huh?
Nalax really? In the last left turn steered full right. And he was on red still, but in front of spam. And he steered full right in the last left turn and gave up with that. And Andy Baguette, I don't know what he did, he released in the last straight. Like at the landing from this last jump, he suddenly got slow. Must be a release though. And let's spam through.
That's the egg.
Yeah. I mean, I had something like that 3 years ago with Virtual in the tour, where people gave up for him. It was, I think, top 4 where I got eliminated. And then in the top 3, it was Virtual and 2 others, and both just DNF'd for him.
That's,
but that's very long ago.
Yeah, so where are my 2 DNFs?
Like, if you start playing, then also play like a
normal Spam
way.
Is doing one for you, maybe? Oh. Spam also slowed down. Okay, maybe you can do a mistake there. I don't think that Spam did it, or did he also do that on purpose?
Nalax wrote, I can't be ours, dog shit map. Would be, I mean, I guess now it didn't really matter.
But why would you play like, I mean, yeah, it doesn't matter, but why would you play until round 14 then, and then retire? Yeah. That's so yuck, huh?
Yeah, that's exactly.
You just don't join at all. That makes like no sense. Nalax, explain yourself, boxing. Oh, that really doesn't make a lot of sense.
I would have easily been in that round, I guess, with my run. I mean, not easily, but it was in for sure. But not
and
really.
Link touching the signs.
Yeah.
Yeah, the signs there are so unnecessary, to be honest.
They are on the ideal line.
Yeah, exactly.
I love it when these kind of signs are on the ideal.
Ha! Did he clip somehow?
No way.
Yeah.
It's a safe round.
Yeah, you're getting saved. Otherwise you do need like 0.1.
Song skip, skipping.
And how many FPS do you have last when you spectate someone?
Let me check. 170, 180, yeah.
Oh.
200.
I have literally 70. Just 70.
Yeah, there's something wrong then. What are your in-game settings actually? Because you can change those quite a bit as well.
Do you mean the graphic settings or other settings?
Yeah, graphic settings. Just show me on your screen, I can compare.
Yeah, I wait for the finish here.
Wait 30 seconds, I have an ad.
But I think that it's not because of the graphic settings. Tell me when you're there. Yeah, Projot, in spectating they are always worse than in playing yourself.
Hello?
But they are also bad when I play. They should be
really
way higher.
Much sense. Okay, I'm there.
Also, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Down. Yeah, I don't have instant on GPU and CPU synchronization. I don't know if that was worse or better. V-Sync I've turned off. I think you want to... Did you want to turn it off in this game? I think so.
Also, V-Sync is...
Yeah, don't put immediate. Put one frame in this one thing.
Yeah.
When you stream, especially.
Yeah, put one frame there, or... Ein Einzelbild.
Ein Einzelbild.
Ein Bild heißt das.
Maybe try V-Sync off.
Oh, actually, might be a Classico today, yeah.
Also, with V-Sync,
like so Germans, those Kantenglättung.
Four Germans in the top 7.
What is with Kantenglättung?
Completely turned off, you don't need it.
Also, with the V-Sync, the thing is, when I turn that off, then I have, then it feels laggy generally. I think that V-Sync is actually G-Sync and Adeo is just too dumb. That is at least the impression that I have from that. And I want G-Sync, obviously.
I mean, I have that turned on in NVIDIA settings. G-Sync.
Yeah, I have it also turned on there. I think that if you don't turn it on in the game, it feels like it would be turned off. And it's very confusing, but it's a very good round, by the way.
Yeah.
That point 0-0-6 is out.
That was also an orange.
Yeah, but good ending, seemingly.
If you have G-Sync on, then you want V-Sync on. If you don't have G-Sync, you don't want V-Sync. Yeah. I mean, what graphics card do you have? Do you have an NVIDIA?
Yes, I have NVIDIA.
No, I don't know if I have it on, actually. I think I have it off, to be honest.
But yeah, I played with exactly that setting a lot around. And I know that if I turn it off, it's worse.
I turn it on and I have 30 FPS less and it looks like shit. But maybe it would need to restart the game or something? What did it do?
Oh, it's close now. We need another good ending.
Oh shit.
Wow.
That's a close one.
Yeah, bro, it's like 0.9 though, but Scrappy's doing 0.5. Scrappy's doing 0.7 now, like, huh?
Yeah,
but look at this, only German and Belgians. What the fuck? Look, like, when you press tap, it's like, yeah. Germans, it's wrong German, it's like, only this.
Yeah, especially with Hendo already away from the server, it's nice. In 8th place, Hobibi is Hobbit, no? Would be another German. And 12th, Nayaki doesn't use the flag. And we don't know if he's German, of course. It's already safe, Purple is a second behind.
How much FPS do you have set on your second monitor? Could be...
Yeah, the second monitor only can do 60.
But her FPS not hertz.
Achso.
I mean, I meant the same thing. Space.
Also, it can only do 60 Hz, but I don't have FPS for that. I don't know.
Now a 95 was a win. Hä? I mean, the thing is, I'm only doing 0.9 now.
With second monitor on and off.
Let's see if I,
Can pull a France and beat Belgium. We'll see.
I mean, if I just shut off the second monitor, then maybe it runs better. Would of course be a shit solution though. But I heard something like that already, yeah. If you have two monitors and one of them has more hertz than the other, that this can cause an issue.
That's close.
Safe?
It's safe.
It's the classic final!
Against Scrappy! Yeah, could get, the thing is, it's gonna be literally random, because like, sometimes he has the 0.7 round or 0.8 round, sometimes I have 0.7, 0.8 round. And it will be whatever or whoever feels like better in the last round, though. Yeah, the thing is, Scrappy has a way better PB already, he already has a 0.7, I only have 81. So.
Yeah, I mean, that's good for you, actually.
Is it?
Surely.
I don't know, we'll see. But once again, a good...
But Project, I'm using, of course, full screen. I know that in that moment when I'm not doing full screen, it's already pretty poor with the FPS and generally laggy.
Let's go.
Yeah, GG.
That's not GG.
It's not GG, but I had a X sword.
Try to go a bit more inside in the next one.
Yeah.
Better. But yeah, having a good run.
Yeah, I mean, I slightly hit the edge in the dings there. Yeah, there's nothing happening.
Perfect ending.
Perfect ending is point two. Yeah, I mean, the B5 and I had a bad start. Do you?
Yeah.
Better performance by Scrappy in the final. Can't deny it. Yeah, I don't know, like I couldn't really drive faster than like 0.8 low. Like even with good start, I think I would have still lost. I don't think it would have mattered, to be honest. I'm pretty sure I have like one bad line. Like I also lost, I was 0.6 behind him, but then I was like 0.2 behind him in the next turn. That's a bit weird.
I wonder if the world record in the end is gonna be driven with a bug slide or without. Yannex was not first,
not me,
but
Everton.
He was not far away and he didn't do the trick line from us, and I think he could have done that with his speed.
Okay.
So I think it would be a bug slide in the end. It's always
possible
to get a
better exit. Actually a twitch at in the final. I don't know, like the bug slide seems really weird because, I mean, you want exit speed, you have like no speed with that. Yeah, okay, Scrappy did a point top 4 world run, or like top 3 kinda. That was not easy. Wait, Chicken Run is a cutter?
My PC is very good though. It should be very good. That's like the issue. Why does such a good hardware get so low FPS?
I mean, Lars, you need. When is the thing starting? At 8, right? Okay, Lars already muted. Hello, guys. My name is Lars. Okay, so guys, I'm gonna try it out real quick. Let's see, maybe I can get something. That's kind of sick, though. That's a cool trick.